As of 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, the President has declared the continental United States under martial law. A nationwide curfew of 7 p.m. tonight has been put into effect, and any citizen caught outdoors between 7 p.m. and 7 a.m. is subject to arrest and detention without counsel. All reserve military personnel and National Guard are ordered to report for immediate deployment. All law enforcement, firefighting, and emergency personnel will be federalized effective immediately. All communication facilities, including the use of landline and cellular telephone facilities, will be reserved for military and rescue operations. In order to halt the spread of this contagion, our nation's borders to Canada and Mexico have been sealed. No longer seek shelter in private residences, no matter how safely protected or well stocked. Retain all ownership records of private property, but do not attempt to transport or defend said property. Rest assured, looters will be prosecuted with deadly force, as will any attempts at vigilantism or secessionist political activity. No questions.
Medical martial law. That's what we're getting ready to see in this country. The signs are all here, okay? They said that, not even a month ago, Ebola, it's not even going to make it into the country. There's nothing to worry about. And now it's here. You're having families being quarantined in the United States under armed guard, even at their own homes. What's the difference? And you still got people out here that are taking no measures to protect themselves at all. You know, we have been conditioned, you know, all of our lives, we've been conditioned, especially the last 10, 20 years, you know, with the swine flu and the avian flu and this flu and that flu. And oh, that way it gets to a point where everybody's like, oh, you know, Ebola, yeah, swine flu, avian flu, this and that, shmata, whatever. And they don't care. Because they've been conditioned to always believe that nothing's going to happen. But then when you are encountered with what's going to be the big one, now that's where the big problem comes in. Because, you know, here we are. No one is taking any measures. People are just out here pumping gas, grabbing the gas pump with their hands. Who used that gas pump before you did? Who was pushing that shopping cart around in a grocery store before you were? Who is the food service worker handling your food when you go out to a restaurant like we all do? You know, even if it's Taco Bell or McDonald's, it doesn't make any difference. Who's handling that food? Yeah. So now you see what I'm saying. You need to start taking precautions, because any day you're going to wake up to a presidential address saying stay home. Don't go out anywhere unless it's absolutely necessary. But another thing is people say, well, let's close the borders. It's already too late. It's already here. The thing you got to worry about now is if it's going to mutate. Is it going to what they're call a gestation rate, where it can be in, and I believe that's correct. Correct me if I'm wrong. But, you know, where it stays in someone's system, like someone could have Ebola or airborne Ebola or some type of mutated form of it and not show signs for a week. Now, how many people have they come in contact with? You know, all it's going to take is a host. In just my opinion, I believe that it's weaponized. And I believe that when it hits a certain host, which here we are coming up on flu season, it's going to create a pandemic that is going to just, it's going to run waves through our society right here in the United States, and it's going to circle the globe. Forget about bugging out. Forget about doing this. I'm at risk just as much as anyone else. Because when is the time where you decide, okay, I'm staying home. I'm not going anywhere. I'm not going to work. I'm not going here. I'm not going there. You know, that's the point. That's the time. That's going to be the critical point, is when you decide it's time to shelter in place. Because if you wait on them to say shelter in place, you're hurting. And we're already hurting. You know, all the bigwigs, everybody that's over the years have moved out to the Ozarks and this and that down in, You know, they all know something's coming. People that are in the know, they already knew that this was going down. So I just think that this flu season, and then Health and Human Services came out today talking about a flu pandemic this year that could kill 60 million people. Well, What if that mutates with a strain of Ebola? Now you got this strain of Ebola mixed with some type of flu strain that is airborne and all over the place. Yeah. So you better start asking yourself, what is your plan? How long are you going to sit around and wait? What measures are you taking out here in the public? Because guess what? We all go out in the public. Again, who pumped the gas before you did? Who handled that shopping cart at the grocery store before you did, before you put your child in the grocery cart? Better be thinking about that. But they're going to use medical martial law to take over the United States. President Obama was the first African-American president. Okay. But he will be the last American president if this goes down the way I think it's going to go down. And you can bank on it. And once the, you know, all of this stuff, all of it, everything, the FEMA coffins, the, you know, the plastic coffin liners that everybody, oh, those are coffin liners, uh-huh. All the detention camps, all these places, all this military equipment they've moved around for the last 5 or 10 years in this country. It's all in place. They're going to start culling this population. You better start taking measures. And when I say taking measures, what I mean by that is stop getting in close proximity to everybody you see out here in the public. Stop touching things without gloves on. Take some precautions. Take the measures. And most of all, please, even if you're not prepared and never have, at least go out and make sure that you have at least 90 days worth of supplies. You need to be able to shelter in place for 90 days where you don't have to go out for anything, period. And that's hard to do. I'm ready. I know a lot of people on this channel's ready. We stay at the ready. So we're ready for this, but what point do we stay home is what I'm asking. So, but for you that's not prepared, get out there. You need to be able to shelter in place for at least 90 days without any contact with anyone, because that's how long it will take for a pandemic to burn itself out. Stay at the ready. Please, get some supplies.